This lecture is all about the phases of the moon and what causes lunar and solar eclipses. By the end of this week, you'll be able to look up at the moon and figure out exactly what phase it's in, and you'll soon be able to impress your friends and family with your amazing lunar skills. Have you ever wondered why we see phases of the moon? Well, it all has to do with the geometry of the Earth, Moon, and Sun. The Moon orbits the Earth and returns to the same position relative to our Sun in the sky every 29.5 days. The thing to remember is that half of the Moon is always illuminated by the Sun and half is always dark. No matter where the Moon is in its orbit, half is bright and half is dark. The amount of illumination we see depends on the Moon's position in its orbit. This is why we see lunar phases. A lunar phase, by definition, is the shape of the sunlit portion of the Moon as seen from an observer on Earth. We'll go through each of the lunar phases next. When the Moon is new, we can't see it. This is because a new Moon is on the same side of the sky as the Sun. A new Moon will rise with the Sun at sunrise and set with the Sun at sunset. It is lost in the glare of the Sun. Each day, the Moon will rise a little bit later, about 50 minutes later. The Moon and the Sun will appear to separate from one another in the sky. Over the next few nights, we'll get to see more of the illuminated portion of the Moon. The Moon is now a waxing crescent. Whenever we see more of the lit portion of the Moon, we say it's waxing. For about a week, it will grow from a tiny crescent shape until it looks like a half circle in the sky. When the Moon looks like this, it's called a first quarter moon. A first quarter moon rises around noon and sets at midnight. This phase is called first quarter because from Earth we see just a quarter of the Moon. Over the next few days, the Moon continues to wax. After first quarter, we say the Moon is a waxing gibbous moon. This phase rises in the afternoon and sets in the early morning hours. 2 weeks after our new moon, the Moon is full. It's on the opposite side of the sky as the Sun, so we see its entire illuminated half. A full moon rises in the east as the Sun sets in the west and is out all night. The full moon will set in the west as the Sun is rising in the east. After a full moon, the Moon begins to wane, and we see less of its illuminated side. A waning gibbous moon rises after sunset and sets after sunrise. 3 weeks after the new moon, the Moon again looks like a half circle, only now the left side is lit. This is the third quarter phase. The Moon will continue to wane. Now it is a waning crescent, and after about 4 weeks, we'll be back to where we started, at the new moon. Now, the way my brain works, I find it useful to put all of the information in a table. I can then work out the rise and set times for each lunar phase by starting with the new moon. I know the new moon rises and sets with the Sun, and as the Moon waxes, it will rise a little later each day. I can therefore figure out that the next phase, the waxing crescent, will rise around 9 a.m. and will set about 12 hours later at 9 p.m. The whole table can easily follow from that. You've probably noticed that we see the same face of the Moon all of the time. This may make it seem like the Moon doesn't rotate, but the Moon does rotate. In this overhead view of the Earth and Moon, the smiley side of the Moon is the side we always see. Watch what happens to the orientation of the smiley face as the Moon orbits Earth. The smiley face makes one full rotation. The Moon does rotate on its axis. The moon rotates exactly once with each orbit, and this is why only one side is visible from Earth. This rotation is called synchronous rotation. And this is just a pretty picture. Perhaps you've seen the moon look like this. The dark portion isn't entirely dark because sunlight reflected by Earth lights up the moon just a bit. This is called Earthshine, or more romantically, the new moon in the old moon's arms. Now we can talk about eclipses. Occasionally, the moon, Earth, and sun line up just right for an eclipse. There are two types, lunar and solar. A lunar eclipse is when Earth's shadow falls on the moon. Earth is much larger than the moon, so during a lunar eclipse, Earth's shadow can cover the entire moon. Therefore, anyone on the night side of Earth can see a lunar eclipse. During a solar eclipse, the moon's shadow falls on Earth. The moon's shadow is tiny, so it can cover only a small portion of Earth at any moment. Therefore, to see a solar eclipse, you have to be within the relatively small pathway through which the shadow of the moon moves. These figures make it look like we should see an eclipse every full moon and every new moon. We don't, so what's going on? The situation is that the moon's orbit is tilted by about 5 degrees relative to the ecliptic plane. The points where the moon's orbit crosses Earth's orbit are called nodes. In order for there to be an eclipse, the new or full moon must occur during one of the periods when the nodes of the moon's orbit are aligned with the sun and Earth. If the sun, Earth, and moon are nearly perfectly aligned, we'll see a total eclipse, either solar or lunar. If it's less than perfect, then we'll see a partial eclipse. The darkest part of the moon's shadow is called the umbra, and it's where people can see a total solar eclipse. The umbra is surrounded by a much larger region where people can see a partial solar eclipse. A total solar eclipse begins when the disk of the moon first appears to touch the sun. Over the next couple of hours, the moon's shadow will cover more and more of the sun's disk. The sky will get dark, it'll get cooler, and crickets will even begin to chirp. Totality only lasts a few moments. You can see the corona at this time, and the stars, too, will become visible. Finally, here is a summary of eclipse conditions. It must be a full moon for a lunar eclipse or a new moon for a solar eclipse. And the moon must be at one of its nodes in order for there to be an eclipse. We'll stop here for now. I know that figuring out moon phases may seem complicated. My advice is to think about what's going on with the motion of the Earth, Moon, and Sun as you are trying to fall asleep at night. If you have trouble sleeping, thinking about the lunar phases is a great way to cure insomnia, and you'll learn astronomy at the same time. Take care, and I will talk to you soon.